Oh yeah, family, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, Morning Motivation. I am Deacon Ford. We're here once again to give God our glory, our honor, our praise. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, family. Let's get into this word and see what the word is saying. Okay. Good morning to you. Good morning. Y'all see it? It's in the word. Thank you for hitting that share button, Sister Allison. It is in the word. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. We getting right into it. Good morning to you, bro Emery. It is morning time. Welcome to the celebration. What are we celebrating, Deacon Ford? Well, we celebrating the breath of life that is in our lungs. God has blessed us and allowed us to see another day. And this is the day that he has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. It is morning time. This morning, y'all, we're looking at Exodus. We'll be looking at chapter 14. And we'll be looking at verse 13 into 15. 13 until 15. Shout out to y'all who are logging on right now. I see you on here, Queen. I see you on here, Deanna. Good morning to you, Sister Stephanie. Good morning to those who are going to log on at other time, at later time. You might log on at your lunch break. You might log on later on this afternoon. Shout out to Instagram over there. My niece Daisy and Big John Russ. Mother and Deacon Robinson, good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Sister Cheyenne, good morning, good morning, good morning to all of y'all. It is a beautiful day. For this is the day, I'm telling you. On that fact alone, that this is the day that the Lord has made. We think about that and we hold that into high reverence. And we will understand that we ought to praise him. We ought to praise him. As me and Olivia said yesterday in Morning Motivation, let us exalt his name together. Once again, Exodus 14, verses 13 through 15 this morning. Let's go ahead and pray and get into this word. See what the word is saying. Father God, as we come to you this morning, in the mighty name of your Son, Christ Jesus, we thank you, we love you, we bless your name, for you are great and you are worthy. As we open and read your word this morning, our prayer is that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, that you will allow your Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth and revelation. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, Exodus 14, verses 13 through 15. The word reads, "And Moses said to the people, do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he shall accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians who you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and he shall hold your peace." And the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel to go forward." May God add a blessing to the hearer, the reader, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. So right now we see the children of Israel, they're being pursued by the Egyptians. They wanted to break free. They wanted to be free from the bondage, but the ones that was oppressing them are now pursuing them to take them back into bondage. Woo, hallelujah. Come on now, that's a word for somebody. Shout out to y'all who still logging on. I see you on here, Sister Natasha. I see you, Missionary Jackson, Evangelist Pons. Thank y'all for being a part of the family. The ones that was pursuing them according to the word were the ones that had oppressed them. And now they're trying to pursue them so that they could put them back into oppression, that they could make them slaves again, so that they could hold them down and hold them back. They wanted to be free from that lifestyle. They wanted to be free from that way of living. And so now they're escaping. But the people that was holding them back, the things that was holding them back, are right behind them. See, what had happened was the foolishness had expired. The expiration date on the foolishness had officially expired, the people of Israel, the children of Israel, had enough, and they decided to leave. They say the foolishness is over. We had enough. We up out of here. But how many of y'all know that sometimes when you say you up out of here, it's not that easy. You still got to go through some things. And so as they was moving, they stepped out on faith. As they was moving, God said, okay, that's all I was waiting on you was to bust a move. I've been waiting on you to bust a move. You've been doing this. You've been talking about what you want to do. You've been talking about how uncomfortable you are, but you ain't never bust a move. So as soon as they decided to bust a move, they started to come after them. They started to pursue them, but God fought their battles for them. Moses tells the people, he said, man, don't be afraid. We're going to stand still, and we're going to see the salvation of the Lord. We're going to let the Lord fight our battles. He's going to bring us through this situation. He's going to make sure that the ones that was holding us back, he got a plan for them. And he said, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he shall accomplish for you. For the Egyptians who you see today, you shall see again no more ever. You shall see again no more forever. Because you decided, because they decided that they was going to step out on faith. They was going to say that we're tired of this. There's a better way of living. I'm going to step out off of this thing. And God said, I'm going to take care of that for you. Brother Jikes. God told him, I'm going to take care of that for you. Because you decided. You decided that you was going to fight against that thing. That you was going to walk away from that thing. That you was tired of living in bondage to that thing. Since you decided and you stepped out on faith. That's right, Mother Hoyt. Since you bust the move. You bust that move. So I got you, man. The Egyptians, that whom you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. Who gonna hold their peace this morning, man? Huh? I know that thing kind of gets you worked up, right? That thing gets you hot. It gets you mad. The Lord will fight for you. And you shall hold your peace. Hold your peace and let the Lord fight your battle. And then it goes on even further and says, the Lord says to Moses, why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel to go forward. Go forward. Step out on faith, man. Go forward. Let the Lord fight your battle. Go forward. Trust in God. Amen. Trust in God and go forward. Trust in God. And go forth. And some of you may know the story. And if you don't, I invite you to continue reading the word. Moses stretches out his rod over the Red Sea. The Red Sea is parted. The children of Israel walk across the Red Sea on dry ground. And as soon as they get safe, the sea takes over and it washes away the Egyptians. He said, nevermore. I see you on here, Brother Dave. What's going on? Good morning to you, my brother. He said, you will see them no more. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. For the Egyptians that you see today, you shall see them again no more forever. And the water washed them away. That's what he want to do. He want to take that living water and wash away your issue. Wash away your bondage. He want to take that same living water. He want to wash away all the dirt and the filth that's in your life. The things that's holding you back. The things that's keeping you chained out. The things that's keeping you enslaved. He want to do that for you, man. The question is, Sister Natalie, good morning to you. The question is will you let him? Will you let him? Will you trust him? Will you go forward? Will you step out on faith so that he can wash away? He can use that water to cleanse. Oh, he can use that water to cleanse all the filthy areas in our lives. Notice I said ours. Got some filthy areas in my life. That's why I said don't take my word for it. Get into the word for yourself. Read the word for yourself. That's Exodus chapter 14 verses 13. You can read the whole thing through the remainder. 13 through 30. 13. Take some time and read the word, man. When you read the word, jump into the comment box. Say, I read my word. Faith over fear, God over everything. Together, we have made love great again. Love has never lost its power. It just lost its popularity. I love y'all. God bless you. Remember, the foolishness has expired. The expiration date on the foolishness is past. It's over with. So now we're in a different mindset. We reflected on the past, being accountable for our actions, and we're preparing for this blessing that God has set for us, man. I love y'all. God bless you. Y'all make sure y'all read your word, man. Please make sure you read your word. Please make sure you read your word. Let the Lord speak to you for himself. Give you a fresh revelation. I just told you what he revealed to me. But let him reveal something to you. I love y'all. God bless you. We signing off. Catch y'all on the next time, family. It's morning time.